What's going on, guys? This is Alex HD and welcome back to another Let's Build episode. I know you guys have been asking for more Let's Builds, and so I thought I'd do one for you today. Also, we did it, you guys. We did 100 subscribers. I'm really, really happy about that, and I really want to thank each and every one of you who has subscribed. And if you're not subscribed, well, thanks for even stopping by and watching my video. That's good enough for me. But for the ones who do subscribe, you guys get to get updated with all the new Let's Build videos and stuff like that, and I really appreciate that. So thank you, you guys. There is an announcement video to come for that. I know in the last video I spoke about doing like a giveaway or something, and I still do want to do that, but I just haven't had the time to I guess make the 100 subscriber video. I don't know what to do for it. I guess it'll be nothing special. I didn't want to waste a Let's Build video on it, and since you guys have been asking for it, I thought I'd just do a Let's Build video, and then I'll have the 100 subscriber special video out shortly. But anyways, today, what are we gonna do? I figured since let's take a look at what we've done. So it looks like we've done the chicken restaurant here. We've also done the spawn shop, which is pretty cool. And then we've also done our fishing dock, which is this one here. All pretty cool designs. You guys can check them out on the Let's Build playlist. And I thought since I did like a rustic fishing house and like kind of a commercial spawn shop or generic spawn shop, and then like a Spanish style chicken house, I haven't really done a modern build. And I thought it'd be pretty fun to make some sort of a modern, I guess like a modern spawn build. By the way, all these buildings that I do can be used in spawn, which is pretty cool. I know a lot of you guys requested some spawn builds, because that's where it's, you know, fun to show off, you know, cool builds, and I guess you guys just need ideas on what to build there. So I thought I'd do, for those of you who like to build, I thought I'd do something like a building shop. This could serve as a house, because it, I guess, all in all, it could serve as a house. But I'm going to be doing a building shop. And you don't really need much except for like a desk and maybe a chest that has some payment information. But other than that, it has to look really, really nice, obviously, because, you know, if you had a dirt house, no one would want to come and get your services. So I've come up with a sort of a decent design for a building company. And some of the textures that we're going to use today are, let's see, I've used this one in the past. A lot of people don't really use this block for building, but we're going to be using the regular clay, just a clay block, which is made by four pieces of clay balls. So we're going to be using that. We're also going to be using a contrasting color. We could use red. Any of these colors could work, I guess, but I'm going to go with the yellow, just because the clay's got like a tint of blue, and I think blue and yellow go really well together. So let's see, let's try to build it. I guess I want to build it on this side because it would go more with this commercial building. So let's start here. So to begin, I just want to lay down, and I don't know why I'm building like this. Let's do this, that's better. Let's do four on the bottom there and then just go up, let's say five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then just make it meet back here like that. All right, so I know it's a little strange, but let's just give it some time. On the back end here, all we're gonna do is actually, let's move this on this side because I don't wanna run into that building. So I'm just gonna flip my design. Normally, the entrance would have been on this side. or on that side, but I'm gonna make the entrance on this side just because we have this path here. It would probably make a lot more sense. So with that said, let's go ahead and do this, Just move it over a little bit. I'm gonna take all this out. Sorry about that. And let's do 2, 3, 4, 5, and let's just bring that around like so. For this side here, all we're gonna do is just bring it out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's just do 6 for now, and then just create a big wall. I've mentioned this in the past, a lot of my builds, I just do like, you know, I build a wall and then I punch out like if I need a window here or something. So that'll come. So if you're like trying to go follow along, then I would recommend just to watch the video first and then wait to see where I punch out the holes and stuff. Anyway, moving on, let's go ahead and bring out this wall here. And now this one's going to be a little bit higher. For modern builds, they use a lot of different elevations. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And we're going to do, let's do 3 after this yellow block. So something like that. Let's reset the time here. Set 0. And then, yeah, that's looking pretty good. And then on this side, actually, yeah. Let's just close it off here. It's not going to be a really big build. I think it'll be just enough for, like we said, all we need is the desk and maybe like a chest. So that's looking pretty good. Since we have a really huge window here, we could add a window here just so it doesn't look so boring. And then we'll go to the same height as this orange block here. And let's actually, I like to put half stone, half slabs for these type of windows. We'll go ahead and insert some stained glass. I'm gonna go with the light gray stained glass pane. Just because, like I said, the clay's got a tint of blue, but it's also got a tint of gray. And I think that'll look really good. Let's go ahead and do the same thing on here. That's looking pretty decent already. Now I want to bring some yellow on this side, but first let's determine where our entrance is going to be. Let's go ahead and let me think about this. Let's skip 3 here and then let's do 2, a double door here. I think that would be good. And let's actually take this up like that and then bring this down on this side like so. And for the doorway, let's go ahead and bring out some quartz stairs and let's just do them upside down like that. Then we'll have a door there, which I think would look really nice. So something like that. And let's go ahead and grab some more of that stained glass and just make 2 windows here. Why not? I think that's looking pretty good. Now I'm going to extend this wall maybe like 2 more. And let's count, how many is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8. Okay, let's go with that for now. And we're just going to bring the yellow back here. It's not going to be a big build. It's going to be actually really small, especially inside. So one block after the doorway here, we're just going to bring up a 3 in width wall and leave it at the same height as this yellow here. Like so. And that's not going to be anything. It's just like a wall that's going to bring out some color in this build. We could even poke out this, probably add a window here. And how's that looking? See, look at that. That's already looking really, really good. This could be, and that's what I was saying, this could be like a really nice house. But again, this is meant for a building company. And I thought I'd do modern for the building company just because even in real life, you'll see a lot of architecture firms that have really nice modern builds. But these firms can build, you know, all, you know, every single different style of build. I mean, they're architects, so. So yeah, I thought I'd go with a modern build. Doesn't mean we only know how to build modern, but you know, I think it just has to represent a nice building and represent that we like nice things. So let's go ahead and continue with our build. And I think I'm gonna close it off with the gray here. Just gonna bring this around to where this meets here. So something like that. Like that, and again I'm just gonna fill in this wall and then poke out any openings that I may need. So now that we got pretty much the outsides figured out, it's looking really good. It's already looking like a commercial building, a nice modern building. So, and that's kind of what we're going for here. Now, looking at our space, let's try to figure out our ceiling. So for the ceiling, what I want to do is add a nice skylight. We got to add a bunch of different features like skylights, double doors, and just some other stuff to show that we, you know, we have some building skills. So I'm going to do this just like that. Should we do 3 in width or 4? Don't want to make it too big. I think that's a nice size. And then for the back here, we could just cover this up maybe. What we could even do is, can we take this wall out? No. What we could do, well, let's go ahead and put in the floor. For the floor, I think I'm gonna go ahead and use the spruce. I used the spruce in my test world, and I think it looks really, really nice. So let's go ahead and just take out this grass here and put in a nice spruce wood flooring. Yeah, that looks nice. It goes well here. We could have another door here. Although, yeah, we could have a door here because it's gotta feel open and I don't want it to be claustrophobic, like, I don't know. I think it'll look nice with another door here. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's go ahead and put the stone like that. And we could even do this so it looks better from the outside. So I think that's looking pretty good. Now, for the interior, I think that's it for the outside, actually, you guys. I know it's really basic, but once we add the details, I think that's what will really make this build, is the details, because the build itself is really simple, really basic. It's just a few rectangles, and sometimes that's all you need to make a really nice build. But let's try to add some details, like adding some, instead of just leaving the grass and putting some flowers, let's go ahead and add some puzzle on the outside. Let's see what that does. I mean, already, just I've only put like 6 blocks down, that looks a lot better. Let's go ahead and do it all the way on the outside here, just like that. We'll probably add some puzzle here as also. Let's fill that in. And then we'll bring it around on this side. And then this would be like a giant garden, maybe. Could even bring it out some. Something like that. Let's go ahead and fill that back in. And then let's go ahead and add some bushes. Of course, we need some bushes. I like the oak leaves because they're really bright green. The jungle leaves work also, but I'm gonna go with the oak. And then we could just add some bushes here and there. Like that. And actually, let's go ahead and take that out. Let's take that out and that. And then let's go ahead and add some bushes there. And that's looking really good already. Let's go ahead and add also some flowers. I really like the oxeye daisy. I'm gonna add one there. Just really basic flowers. We don't want to overdo it. I like the azure blue. do a little bit of that. Should we do one more here? Why not? And then let's also use, throw in some color. We'll do an orange tulip right by the entrance here. Oops. Just like so. We could add some color with a big flower here. So let's do, I like the lilacs. Something like that. Let's actually swap that. Something like that, right? Yeah, I think that looks really, really good. And actually, I kind of want to curl this back here. And it might be too many here, so we can actually show some pods though. Don't want to block it all, so let's go ahead and leave that. And then maybe add about one more flower. Something like that. So that's looking really good. I like that a lot, and I'm going to stick with that. So now we could simulate some sort of an entrance. For example, we can grab some, don't want to use mossy, gotta make it, keep it clean. What I did on one of my multiplayer servers, so we used a bunch of combinations of the new blocks and some of the and some of the old blocks to make a really unique path, and I think it looked really good. Where's the cobblestone? Here it is. What else did we use? I think we used smooth stone. And so let me just skip through this because I know you guys probably don't want to see this. So I'll be right back. Alright guys, welcome back. So I've done a couple of things here. First of all, I said I was going to do that pattern of different blocks for the path, but I want to keep it nice and clean, nice and modern and sharp. So I thought I'd just go with these new blocks, the polished andesite, and I think it looks really well. It fits really well. The colors are similar to the clay, and I kind of like it. So as we come along, also I don't think I changed any of the bushes, but I've done a couple of things, and let me show you. But as we come in, you'll notice that I shrunk the building, and you're gonna be like, what the hell, why? Well, no specific reason why. I just didn't want too much space on the inside. Like I said, we really don't need that much. I had done this one in my test world, and I think I'm gonna do the same thing as far as the interior. I could have come up with something if I kept it a little bit longer, but it wouldn't have made much difference. And I just want to help you guys as far as block materials. It'll just remove a lot of blocks actually for a whole wall here. So I basically just instead of 8, I think it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 in width instead of the 8. Originally we had this whole back wall going all the way out here, and then the yellow block was going here. So I just took off the whole gray back wall clay. I moved the yellow in, and then the door, it was this one and this one here, I just moved it over one block. So instead of a 3-gap here, we have a 2-gap, which also works. So it's a little bit more compact, and that's kind of what we're going for. And I mean, it looks similar. It's not much of a difference, but let's just roll with it. But besides that, that was the most dramatic change. I've inserted some pressure plates here and some iron doors. Also, I took off the stone half slabs for the foot entrance, and I went with these new blocks. I figured we should start using them because we have them. I'm not used to building with these new blocks, but why not? So and I like how these pressure plates blend in really nice with the polished andesite. I've also added a little header here with the quartz half slabs right on top of the doorway, which actually works really, really nice. I kind of like that a lot. So as we go in, same thing on the inside. Although I wanted to do something with this, I think that we should take off this row. Let's put the clay, and let's do something on the inside. I also, since I brought the back wall in, I added a window here. We can add some panes instead of blocks, and that doesn't look so bad also. But I kind of like how the blocks look. for this window here. It kind of adds some ceiling lighting, and we need to figure out a way to get out of here. So let's go ahead and add these here. There you go. And I think that looks nice. Otherwise, it'd be too plain, just a big gray clay wall. So those windows look actually really, really nice. We could even, however, I don't know about this. We could add those trap door effect, the fence gate, something like that, and then we'll add. Can we add these on top? Oops. Nope, I didn't think so. I think I normally just add some half slabs. We'll do the quartz since we did them on the doors. And I think that looks okay. We can take that off if we don't like it. How about some carpet? Where's our carpet? Here we are. Let's try. Do we want to use light gray? How about yellow since we, orange? Since it'll go fairly similar with this. Whoa, that's kind of off. Well, let's see. How's the yellow look? Well, let's try both. It's not much. It's not much of a difference, but the orange kind of adds another color. And that's not too bad, actually. I kind of like the orange, how it pops out like that. It's up to your preference. How about let's try one more? Oh, that looks like a keeper. It kind of blends in really nice with the clay. It looks like it's clay. Let's go with that for now. I mean, of course, you guys could change it. But what else did we do? We put in this. We did the doors. We did the footsteps. I think that's about it. We added that window. We could add like some sort of a cool design. With the windows, I like to do that. Let's do this darker gray, and I'm just gonna do a letter A in the ceiling. Since my name is Alex, I think that might be pretty cool. I like that. It looks cool. Let's stick with that. On this side, we continue the polished andesite for the path. We have it curling around a little bit. And since I moved this wall, it looks a little bit awkward, so let's add. I think that's a little bit more rounded off. What I like to do for these gardens here, I like to give it like a border, so it looks like it's like this has been planted in like it's fertilizer and it's part of a little garden or something. And then I like to just add some pressure plates so it looks like a nice little border, nice little garden border. And and then we could add some bushes here. I'm gonna do the fence. I can't wait till I get the I mean, I guess I could get it, but the update with the fences, the colored fences, I think that's a game changer. Let's go one more. And I think that looks really, really good. We could also add some flowers. I think that's okay. I mean, that's something we can play around with. At night, time set 20,000. So for lighting out here, I think the simplest thing to do is to just add a piece of glowstone, and let's grab a brown stained glass. We just come back here, pop two out, and let's throw one down like that. Yeah, I mean, it's not that noticeable unless you're like actually coming over here. I think it blends really well. So I think that looks really nice. As far as the outside, I think we're done. We could add some bushes, however. I like this one here. I don't like this one, so let's go ahead and remove that. And to be honest, I'm completely fine with that being like that. I don't want to overdo it. And I think that looks really good already. We could even add, don't know about this, I might take this off, but how about a grass block here? Come on. And then we'll do some, let's get some fertilizer. Where are you at? And I know this video is dragging, but we're pretty much done. I'm just gonna show the interior. Where are you? Bone meal. I probably passed it. Let's do that. So it's like a little bit of a green roof. I think that looks okay. We could add some more lighting down here. And again, do the brown stained glass. I always worry about lighting. I know a lot of people tend to forget that, but I think that's perfect lighting. You got the lighting on the side, which is illuminating around the corner here, as you can see on the floor. And then this one that's illuminating right by the door, which is kind of pointing where the doors are at. And that, I guess people tend to walk towards the light. And I think that looks really, really good at night. Yeah. So for the interior, not going to be much. We don't have that much room, but I figured it's an office. Let's use some bookshelves. Here we are. Bookshelves. And what I want to do is actually just stack them like at random. I think I had, let's see how I had it. I was using some really vibrant colors for the interior. Some like really expensive leather, not leather, but some really expensive orange couches right in the center. We could use a light here. Let's use a redstone lamp. Do that there. And then here we'll use the lever to turn it on. Something like that. And then we'll just stack this up like that. Make it look like some sort of a bookshelf. I know that looks really weird, but give it some time. I've done this in the past. If you've seen my Let's Play episodes, I came up with a pretty neat design for bookshelves. I think this looks like a really cool bookshelf. Let's do that, and then let's add a few more bookshelves here. And then we'll close that off. So the dirt actually works on top because we're actually covering this up anyway. I think that looks really, really good. So let's go ahead and keep that. We could add a wall here. And that might not work. Well, it doesn't have to be a tall wall, but this doesn't look good. How would it look if we took this out? Let's take a look from the outside. Does it throw it off a little bit? Yeah. Let's go ahead and keep it. Oops. Let's keep the window. And let's put this back. And to be honest, I'm actually kind of fine with that. I'm fine with that. If that bugs you guys could take the window out. But I think that looks really good. On the corner here, we'll go ahead and add the desk. And add some more bookshelves, act like a little desk. We'll add probably another one on top. And then we'll add just some bushes. like that. I think that's looking really good. I like the color scheme. It looks really good. Let's pull out some quartz stairs. And all we want to do is just create a really cool counter desk like that. And I think we're done. For this, we could add... I'm just going to do this. Oh no. Let's go ahead and grab that back. Let's actually do this. And then I'm just going to do the snow trick so I can put a villager in. And it's 7 layers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So now if we grab ourselves a villager, let's just throw one in. And there we go. And that's our front desk clerk. But I think that's it for the interior. There's not much left to do. We could add just a little detail, like maybe a flower pot here. Oops, excuse me. And then I love how the azure bluettes look inside the flower pots. That's perfect. We could add like mats here eventually, if you guys like that. And how about a flower pot? This might cut us out, or at least our walkway a little bit. But this is completely optional. I think I like this a lot. We got the lighting for the interior, which will do just fine. And I really, really like this. I like the interior. It's really nice and cozy, but it's really modern also. This looks really cool from the inside with our villager there. One more thing we could add here before I let you guys go is maybe some buttons. How does that look? That actually looks really good. I actually really like that. How does it look here? I like that. That's, I mean, again, optional, but I think that looks really good. I'm gonna leave these tall grass here. That looks really weird how it's off-centered. Oh well. But I think that's gonna do it, you guys. Here's a floor plan from the top. Pretty simple design. Like I said, the building is not much, but what gives it, or what makes this building is all the little details. And I can't stress that enough, but you guys just take your time on the details. I mean, it really goes a long way. I hope you guys did enjoy this video. For my next video, again, I am going to upload that 100 special video and do a giveaway. But for my next Let's Build video, I do plan to do some sort of like a pet shop, because I know we have rabbits out on the new snapshot. And I'm kind of excited to play around with that. So stay tuned for that. If you guys have any suggestions, comments, leave them down in the comment section below. I'd really love to hear your feedback. Let me know if you guys like this build, if you want to see the pet shop, or if you want to see something else. I'd like to hear your guys' feedback. But again, thank you all to the subscribers. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you guys all in the next one. See you guys later. Peace out.